Hello, my dear students. Good morning. Hope you all are fine. Dear students, in our last class, social, we discussed about the chapter 5, Important Monarchs of India. Is it? All of you memorized that one. From that chapter, we learned that main important rulers of India. Right? And their dynasty also. What all are they, children? Anybody memorize? Okay. Then say together. What are they? So, dear children, main 5 dynasty we learned in our last class. What all are they, children? Main 5 dynasty, what are they? Mauryan dynasty, Gupta dynasty, Vardhan dynasty, Chola dynasty and Mughal dynasty. But these two only we discussed detail, right? Mauryan and Gupta. Did you memorize, children? Okay, very good. Then, who were the rulers of Mauryan and Gupta dynasty? Okay, say together. Who were in Mauryan dynasty? Chandragupta, Maurya and then Ashoka. These are the two rulers of Mauryan dynasty. Who all are they? Chandragupta, Maurya and Ashoka. Very good. Then what about Gupta dynasty, children? Just check your memory. In Gupta dynasty, related to Chandragupta name. That is Chandragupta II. He was the ruler of Guptan dynasty. Clear? And today I am going to discuss with you about Vardhan dynasty, Chola dynasty and Mughal dynasty. So we can learn these three details. Clear? So children, after the decline of Gupta Empire, Harshavardhana became the ruler of Vardhan dynasty. Okay, and he ruled 40 years. And Kannauj was the capital of his country, Kannauj. And he followed Buddhism. These all are the main achievement of Harshavardhana. And he followed the Buddhism. And he encouraged the learning. And he built many stupas. And he sent one mission to China to build a diplomatic relationship between China and India. And his main glowing account of life is recorded in Harshacharita. Okay, these all are the main importance of Vardhan dynasty. Children, next we can check the Chola dynasty. Okay, in Chola dynasty, Rajaraj Chola, who was the emperor of Chola dynasty. Rajaraja Chola. Okay, and he also known as Rajaraja the Great. Rajaraja the Great. And he conquered many countries. What is conquered mean, children? Conquered means under his control. Like many places. Chera, Pandyas, Gangas of Mysore. And also the Sri Lanka, Maldives. Okay. And he want to become enlarge his kingdom. And he also known as Mummudi Cholan. What is Mummudi? Mummudi Cholan means Chola who wear 3 crowns. Like Chera, Chola and Pandya. Okay, 3 crowns he wear. Chola, Chera and Pandya. And he built the famous temple. That is Brihadvishara temple at Kannauj. Kannauj is the capital of Chola dynasty. We know the difference here. Kannauj. Kannauj is the capital of Vardhan dynasty. Here Kannauj. Kannauj is the capital of Chola dynasty. Clear? Next we are going to check about the Mughal dynasty. So dear children, I know that you already heard about the Mughal emperor, right? It was the richest emperor in India, right? And in Mughal emperor, we need to learn about Akbar. Akbar, he was the 3rd emperor of Mughal dynasty. Okay? And he was very kind and urban gentleman. Enlarged his kingdom into Gujarat, Bengal and Rajput like that. Okay. And he introduced Deen Ilahi or Divine Faith. That is, it is a concept merging of all the truths of every religion like Hindu, Muslim, Christians. And he respected other religions also. Okay. And he introduced a jizya. Jizya means it is a tax on non-Muslims. He introduced that jizya. And he had a great scholars in his court. That we call, we know that, Navaratna or Nayan Jewels. And some of the example like Birbal, you already heard about Birbal, wits and humorous, right? And then Tanzim, like a famous singer, in Akbar's court, and Abdul Faisal, a chief minister of Akbar's court. These are the famous scholars of his court, and he built many stupas and monuments like Agra Fort, Fatehpur Sikri, and Humayun's tomb, like that. So he also known as the Akbar the Great. Now I am going to teach you about the Shah Jahan, grandson of Akbar. Akbar's son's name is Jahangir. Jahangir's son's name is Shah Jahan. You can check it. So dear children, as a grandfather, Shah Jahan also want to expand his country to Bijapur, Ahmednagar, like that. And the period of Shah Jahan's rule is regarded as golden age of Indian architecture. Golden age of Indian architecture. And he built many stupas and monuments like Red Fort, Jama Masjid, and Great Taj Mahal at Agra. We already know about the Taj Mahal. Taj Mahal he built for the memory of his beloved wife. What's the name of wife? Mumtaz Mahal. And it is the finest example architecture of Mughal Empire. What is Taj Mahal, right? That golden age of Indian architecture time, it was very famous for their poetry and musician and architecture, right? And after that, Shah Jahan's son Aurangzeb himself declared as the king of Mughal Empire, Aurangzeb. And Shah Jahan kept in captivity till he died, which place? Agra Fort. Okay, so these all about the dynasty. Clear all of you? And at the end of this chapter, we learn five dynasty. What are the children? Everybody have to say together. Gupta dynasty, Maurya dynasty, then Chola dynasty, Vardhan dynasty, and Mughal dynasty.
So students, now it is an activity time. All should have to open your notebook and you should write what all are the dynasty we learned in today's class. That you have to write in your notebook neatly, and who all are the rulers of this dynasty. Okay, who all are the emperor of this dynasty. That also you have to write in your notebook neatly and learn it. Okay, and today's topic question for you. Say the names of Mumudi Cholan. What all are the places which coming under Mumudi Cholan? So you have to say the name in my personal WhatsApp. Okay.
So all should have to read the chapter 3 times. And we can meet in our next class. Thank you.